So, first step we want to do here is calculate the number of bits required. So, we want to find out how many bits do we need to borrow in order to accommodate 8 networks. And here's how we do that. We take the value 2 to the power of n, and that's going to equal the number of networks required, and n here is the number of bits needed. Now remember, we have to take it to the power of n. This isn't n times 2, this is 2 to the power of n. So, we say 2 to the n equals 8 networks. We can solve that with logarithms. So log base 2 of 2 to the n equals log base 2 of 8. Once we do the logarithm, we can use a function of logarithms where we can take the exponent and move it out as a multiplier to the logarithm. And then solve this equation and we get 3 bits. Pretty easy, right? Not math heavy at all. Ross, what's a logarithm? Well, yeah. Logarithms are a mathematical operation that allows us to solve for exponents. We will never, ever, ever, ever do this. This is exactly why I had you build that nifty little subnet calculator a couple slides ago. Now, this little subnet calculator has all those logarithm functions built into it. We don't even need to worry about the math. If you can make this calculator, which we saw isn't that hard to do, we can then find the number of bits we need to borrow in order to accommodate 8 networks. So if I look down in my networks column and find 8, and then I move over to my bits column, I find 3. Well, I'll be, that's the same answer we found when we tried to do it with logarithms. So, I need to borrow 3 bits from my host portion and put them into network portion, and that will allow me to have 8 more networks. But what if it's different? What if we need 10 networks? So instead of 8, what if we needed 10? Well, if we needed 10 networks, we have to go down our networks column here. We see we have a value for 8 and a value for 16, but none for 10. And that's okay because we always round up. So if we need 10 networks, we have to go up to 16, which means we need to borrow 4 bits. In our particular case, we only need 8 networks. 8 networks requires 3 additional bits. Let's look at now how to calculate each one of the network addresses so that we can then assign those network addresses to each of our sites that we need network connectivity to.